It's absolutely fantastic to have here with us. Can you start by telling us what you think fans are going to get from this experience?
So much. I mean, it's a very unique experience to really have a feel of what it was like to make these films and to walk around the sets and see how much work is put into them. And I think it's really great that people can share that with us.
Fans can't wait for this extraordinary opportunity. What's your most special memory from the Potter set?
I've got so many memories. I remember the first time ever walking onto the Great Hall and seeing all the food on the table and hundreds of people in there, and it really did blow you away. And I hope that people will get that same feeling when they see the Great Hall as well.
Final question. We're big supporters of Childline, the UK national charity aimed at helping young children cope. I mean, have you got any advice for young people about how you cope with adversity and sort of difficult things?
Being ginger, I think. I'm used to getting a bit of flack for that. And, I think you should I've never really tried to hide it. Just ignore it and just do what you want to do. We've been so lucky to work with amazing cast and a real variety of different directors as well, which, I mean, it was an education, really. We learned a lot on the way. And also all the creative people that you don't usually get a mention. I think for this attraction, they really get celebrated because so much work goes into these stuff, and it's great.
Message for Potter fans before you leave?
Come here to Watford and see this amazing attraction.
What do you think fans are going to get from this experience?
I think the best thing is going to be the feeling they get that, you know, that they actually are in Hogwarts, and you know, knowing that this is where the films were made. That's just such a real. That's something that you can look at pictures and you can kind of examine the films, but you can't know what it feels like to walk through the doors in Hogwarts. And everyone wants to. Everyone was kind of a bit regretful when they didn't get their letter. You know, their letter to Hogwarts at 11. And this is like, you can pretend you did. You can pretend that happened and you're in Hogwarts for a few hours.
Talking about your own experiences, what's your most lasting and special memory from set?
There's so many great ones. I think meeting J.K. Rowling was special for me because she's such an inspiration to me, kind of an idol, you know? And being able to meet her and have a conversation with someone who's so who's done so much and is still so modest. That was cool.
I mean, you're a Potter star and a Potter fan. What makes just this series so special and unique?
I think the fact that it's an escape for us, but it's still real people. You know, they're very much the people we can relate to, but they're living in a different world and they have different problems. So, and I think it's like, that's why this tour is so great. When you enter, you're like, you forget that you're a muggle, you forget of all your problems.
Talking about relating to characters, apart from your own, who's your favourite?
There's so many. I love Snape. I just have a feel for him. He's just, you know, because he's such a hero, and like he kind of spent his whole life with no one loving him, and not, I think he has so much that he wants to love, but he had a terrible childhood and everything, and I just think he's such a hero that he went through all that and sacrificed so much. I think about him a lot.
Our final question, talking about coping, we're big supporters of Childline, the UK charity aimed at helping young people cope with adversity. What advice would you give to young fans about dealing with difficult emotions or trouble?
I would say write them down. That really helps. And tell someone. Don't be afraid to talk to other people. Don't be ashamed, because everyone has flaws. I think reading is always a help. Like when I was younger, happy and had such a good family, but I think, you know, anything you go through with other people, you know, bullying and things like that, books are such a great place to kind of find wisdom and to find that you have a safe place or something. I think writing down your feelings and talking to people, don't feel ashamed.
Anything you'd like to say to Potter fans before you say goodbye?
Thank you. Thank you for supporting us so much and after all these years for still being here to support us. And I hope they come and enjoy the studio tour. I think it's a great experience. Yeah.
Bonnie, it's fantastic to have you with us. Can you tell us just a little bit about your own experiences on set and what you think this exhibit is going to give fans?
I guess it's, you know, it's the ultimate experience for any fan, really. It's stepping on the actual sets that we shot on, and it's just so nice to hand it over to people, really, and to allow the fans to explore and see it for themselves.
What's your lasting special memory from set?
Ah, God, there's lots. From 10 years of being on them, there's a lot, you know, that we all experience there. And I think that'd be nice when we go on, you know, the sets now, just all those memories come flooding back.
Do you have a message for fans before you leave?
I hope they, you know, enjoy our studio and get to see it for themselves, really.
Got a whole band of Gryffindors here, haven't we? Not one of you's even... Sorry, what are you saying?
What can fans get from the studio experience?
Just a real insight to how the Harry Potter films were made, I suppose. And a real sense of what it takes to make great films. You don't have to be a Harry Potter fan to really enjoy this. There's so many wonderful different elements of behind the scenes that people get to check out for the first time.
Do you have a favourite moment on set?
I guess just walking into the Great Hall for the first time was a pretty unforgettable experience, and it's incredible that it's still here standing today for other people to enjoy it as much as we did.
I hear the cast are like a family. Who do you miss the most?
You can't do that. You can't miss it, pick one person. There are hundreds, and it's not just the cast, it's the crew. And any excuse to come back to Leavesden just to enjoy the family spirit. So yeah, good to be here.
Do you have a quick message for fans before we leave you?
Sure, come and check it out. This was built for you guys. Without your continued support, we would never have got this far. So I hope you enjoy it.
They're going to get a taste of the magic that we were lucky enough to be part of for those 10 years making the films, and they can finally step inside the studios and experience the amazing sets, costumes, props and stuff.
What do you think is going to surprise or blow people away the most about this tour?
Just the scale of everything, how big stuff is and how much stuff was actually created in reality and wasn't just cleverly programmed into a computer. You know, I think that's what will surprise people.
This is obviously going to give people their own experiences of the production and the set, but I mean, what's your most lasting and special memory of being on set with Potter?
I think it's the people I work with over the 10 years. You know, a lot of them came on film to film to film, and we all became very close, and this studio is a very special place. You know, it's where Harry Potter was born as far as the films are concerned, so this is, for some fans, this is like hallowed ground.
It really is. Now, I mean, fans have their own favourite characters and their own favourite film. Could you pick for those yourself?
Oh, man. Favourite films? I loved Prisoner of Azkaban. I loved Deathly Hallows Part 2. Favourite characters? Of course, mine. But apart from that, I love Snape. It's a great character.
Everyone loves Snape. Why do you think people love Snape?
I don't know. He's just so odd, isn't he? He's just so eccentric, so weird. I'd like to have played Snape. I also think David Bradley's Filch was terrific. I mean, there's loads of great characters in there, aren't there?
Do you want to say anything to Potter fans before you leave?
Thanks for all your support over the last, I mean, it's more than 10 years now. And thanks for the inspiration, which is what's behind this place here. And come and experience it, because it's definitely like nothing you would have ever seen before.
What do you think fans are going to get from this studio experience?
I think they will get the experience of not only seeing the sets, but they'll get a unique insight into how the process of filmmaking and how and what it was, hopefully see what it was like for us to actually be there, and the behind the scenes look of how it was designed, and how the costumes and the creatures and what it was like to fly on the broomstick, because they only see the finished product. And for them to see what we saw, I think, will be a unique experience. Yeah.
Talking about your own experience, how did you get into your character, and why do you think fans loved him so much?
I think they probably loved him because he was not only a scary figure or a self-important figure and an angry figure. He was, I think it was the humour that made, and the fact that he loved his cat. And we're a nation of animal lovers and cat lovers, so I think his love of his cat made him more human. And his, as I said, his humour, because he didn't find himself funny, he took himself very seriously. But I was so glad when the audiences laugh and find him funny. Yeah.
Beyond your own character, who's your favourite character in the series? Is there anyone in particular that you just love watching on screen?
Well, Michael Gambon is, for me, the greatest British actor, and I and he's a personal friend. And so I've always enjoyed watching him work, and it was a pleasure. And people like Maggie Smith and the other, you know, really great, great British actors. And to get the opportunity to work with them on something like this, for me, was a pleasure, you know. And Dan Radcliffe and Rupert and Emma, to watch them develop as actors over the 10 years and get better and better at what they do, I thought they were terrific.
Potter's touched the lives of people all over the world. What do you think it is about it that makes it so magical, and what do you think people take away from it?
I just think it's the sheer scale of Joe Rowling's imagination that produced so many rich characters. And it is, I know it's uniquely British, and it could only, there's something so British about it, but the fact that it's so popular all over the world is amazing to me. And I think it must be something to do with, we all, there's a part of us maybe that always believes or hopes there is such a thing as magic. You know,
I think. You have a message for Potter fans before you leave?
Yeah, behave yourselves, all right.
How excited are you about the grand opening?
Oh, very excited. I can't wait to go in, but I've just found out that you can ride on a broomstick.
Who wouldn't want to do that?
Who wouldn't want to do that? What can be so wrong in doing that?
Why do you think it is so important for Harry Potter fans to have this kind of intimate experience with the film?
Because I think that so many films are not made like this. This is the only film I've ever been on that you actually build entire sets that you walk on that are in three dimensions, and that everything's actually, the paintings are oil paintings and the wood is real wood. I mean, normally it's all polystyrene and people go, don't lean on that. It's not made of metal. You know, but this was all the real stuff, and it was built and crafted and designed for this film. So it was a privilege to work on it, and I'm glad that we can share that privilege with people and they can see all the artistry that we have in the British film industry here.
People are going to have their own wonderful experiences of the sets, but what's your lasting, most special memory of being on set for Potter?
Well, there'll be Malfoy Manor, definitely, and the last scene, the great battle scene. That was quite extraordinary.
I mean, what do you think made the final scene just so special and unique?
The fact that she wrote such an epic film, and then again it was filmed in such an epic way. We really did have, you know, hundreds of extras on both sides, and then all the leading cast in front of them. And we had three sets of that last castle, one before the battle, during the battle, and after the battle. And to film that in real time and hear somebody say action and just do a 7-8 minute take of people fighting, the people who prepared for this scene for months, I mean literally for months of building every, you know, wand and bit of detail, I mean that's fantastic. The best dressing up game you could possibly be involved in. Yeah.
I mean, playing it with some fantastic young performers as well, can you tell us a little bit about what it was like working with Tom, Daniel, Rupert particularly?
I think Tom in that scene, when I said to him, you're right, I said, are you nervous? And he said, yeah. I said, well, you know, I've been waiting for this for 10 years. And you look at him and go, oh, you're not joking. You really have been waiting for this for 10 years. You've known this for 10 years. And that's quite, I mean, I'm never going to have that experience again, you know.
Potter's touched the lives of people all over the world. What kind of message do you think the film gives or delivers?
That to do good is much more difficult, complicated, braver, and more admirable than to get the quick fix. And our society is all about quick fixes. And this isn't. And that's why I think that a new generation, and people are so down on you, the younger generation, and go, oh, all they do is this and all they do is that. It's like, well, if that's all you give them, what can you expect? Potter gives them something else. And I think that's great.
How do you feel about being at the Grand?
I'm really excited. I mean, I haven't seen it, so I'm very excited about seeing it and knowing what's happening and the exciting things that are there. So yeah.
What do you you most looking forward to seeing again or seeing for the first time?
Privet Drive, I think, because that's home and that's where certainly I spent all my time, and the house itself and the stairs and the cupboard and my bedroom and all those kind of little details are really, really excited about being reacquainted with that. So, yeah.
This tour is obviously going to give fans their own wonderful experience of the production of the films, but what's your most special, lasting memory from being on?
I had a lot of fun doing the underground stuff with the Dementor, and I thought that was the underpass, sorry, not underground, underpass stuff. And I thought that was really kind of, just the whole filming of that was very exciting, and dealing with that magical element that perhaps I've never really had before. You know, I've had all the tail stuff, but that kind of scary element with the Dementor was really exciting to kind of play with. So, yeah.
I mean, your character does have quite a rough time of it in the films. Why do you think people enjoy seeing that?
I think it is the fact that everyone knows Dudley. Everyone has a Dudley. Everyone has, you know, in their kind of baggage of life, has a bully, knows a bully, has been bullied, or is a bully. So there's that element, and the fact that he redeems himself, I think, is a quality that I think that is nice about him. And I think he's not bad. He's bad because of his parents, and blame the parents. No, he's bad because of what they make him do and make him think, and how. So I think it's nice that he kind of has a moment of individuality at the end and realization. So, yeah.
Are you ready for the grand opening of the tour tonight?
I'm very, very, very ready. I came and saw it yesterday when I was doing some interviews, and it's truly amazing.
Fans who haven't had a chance to see it yet, what are they going to get to experience?
Epicness on a massively huge scale. They're going to see all the sets. They're going to see all the costumes. They're going to really be able to get an intimate insight in what it was like to work there.
There's a treasure trove of stuff in there, but what were you most excited to see again?
I was most excited to see something I'd never seen, which was the model of Hogwarts. It will blow your mind. It's absolutely amazing. You're going to love it.
Preparing mind to be blown.
Yeah. Absolutely, like this.
No, I mean, it's an amazing experience to look at this, but you've been on set, you've been part of the films. What's your most special memory from set?
Actually, I was thinking about it. I saw George, you know, the one that plays Shacklebolt. And one of my good memories is, like, in between takes, just sitting around and singing Otis Redding, Sam Cooke with him, just, like, singing in between takes. He's brilliant. I love him. I hope you get an interview with him.
Well, we love talking to all the Potter people. Now, in terms of characters, other than your own wonderful character, who's a lot of fans, one of their faves, who's your favourite character?
Bellatrix, definitely.
Why?
Because she's naughty and sexy and evil. It's great.
I like all of those words. Great. And I mean, what do you think makes Harry Potter just so unique and just magical for fans all over the world?
It kind of deals with massively timeless themes of friendship. I really like the fact that it's a kid's book. It deals with death and how you deal with death and love and evil. It's got kind of all the components to be a fantastic saga. And
I guess final question before we let you go and enjoy tonight. Do you have any special message to Potter fans watching this all around the world? Anything you'd like to say?
Get your ass here immediately. It's amazing.